This is Face the Music, a Jeff Lynne's Electric Light Orchestra song-by-song podcast. Episode 190, On My Mind.
Now and again, I think about her, about the way things were. Thinking about her now is the way that it is. I think I know what's right and what's wrong. I never listen to people who lie, and I remember the days, sad and tender moments that she had.
A whisker for your thoughts.
I'm Eric Paul Johnson.
And I'm Eric Winsenson.
What are you doing to us, Jeff Lynne? Do you need to have a refresher course on how to put together an album? The good stuff goes on the album proper. The clunkers are the bonus tracks. So this should have gone on the album, not as a bonus track. And to top it all off, to make it even more harder to find, it's a bonus track on the expanded issue released only in Japan. It's not on Apple Music. It's not on Spotify. You can probably rip it from YouTube or do what I had to do to be able to have the song here to use on the show. I asked ELOologist Kai Kuyama, can you send that over to me? So that's how I had to get it. You probably figure out that with my little rant here that I like the song. I like it a lot. It sounds different. The keyboards here that Jeff Lynne's using, I've never heard that kind of synth keyboard sound on an ELO song. The guitar is all distorty. It's almost grunge-like distorted guitar, which I've never heard on any ELO song before. I've heard distorted guitar, but not quite in that distortion sound. And I really love the pre-chorus when that distorted guitar comes in and Jeff's voice sounds like it's coming through a good telephone. It's freaking awesome. And I really dig the waka 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 bit of the guitar thing or synth thing that happens before it explodes into the chorus. The drums are Jeff Lynne, but he's doing something here to pick it up so that it's not just snare, bass, snare, bass. The people who always ride me, like, say, Corey Gomel, that, oh, you just want Out of the Blue Part 2 or something that sound like that era. And I have to keep telling people, no, I want Jeff to do something that sounds different. I wouldn't have a problem if he did something that sounds like that era, but I want him to do something that sounds different from what he's been doing for the last 30 years, which is rehashing armchair theater. And this is different. This sounds different, and I freaking love it. You know, I wasn't asking for him to just reinvent the wheel or go off into some sort of completely different direction, which is what El Dorado was and what Time was. Because those didn't sound like ELO that came before. I just want something that sounds different, or uses different instruments, or makes them sound different, instead of just, here's Cloud 9 again. So, this is it. There's so much about this song that sounds different than what came before, which is why I like it. A lot. I listened to it a lot this morning. About an hour, I just listened to it over and over again, because I friggin' love the song.
I like it as well. Yeah, it surprised me because as soon as I heard it, I went, here's another one of these instances where we've got a bonus track that belongs as part of the album, not stuck to some edition that you have to go through a whole bunch of rigmarole just to get a copy of.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I like it for all the reasons you do. My only problem with the guitars is it sounds like they were recorded in a completely different session and then tacked on. I think that might be the only reason it's a bonus track, is because maybe he didn't finish all the production he wanted to do on it. But other than that, yeah, it's different than everything else on the album. It's got the loud guitars, which I appreciate. It's got vocals that start off almost like 1970s ELO, but then go into something different. the music sounds like Jeff Lynne doing something for the 2010s.
Yeah.
It doesn't sound like rehashing the 70s, the 80s, or the 90s. It sounds like, hey, I've got some ideas. Let's go ahead and do this. But let's banish them to the outer regions of this album.
Yeah.
So nobody will hear it and nobody will ask me to do it again.
Well, I'm asking. I'm demanding. Do it again. Yeah, it's not like radically different, like suddenly going from Xanadu to Time. It's still great. It's still a bit zoomy, but not so zoomy that it's like, okay, he's doing this again. And I think one of the things that makes it kind of zoomy is that the chorus is pretty much note for note the chorus from Lonesome Lullaby. Cry, baby, cry. Only this time he makes it better. Aside from the music, I think the addition to it that makes it even better, so much, much better than the chorus on Lonesome Lullaby, is Jeff Lynne's bop, bop, bops going on in the background. When it all comes together in that chorus, it just sends me over the top. It's a great freaking song.
Yes, it is. And sometime he's got to put together a compilation, not of the stuff that he's already done, not of a bunch of re-recorded stuff that ends up combined with the original stuff. They keep complaining about the 50th anniversary. We'll just dump this.
Here's a playlist, and we'll put some of the stuff from 2012 on here, because nobody's adding the 2012 stuff to their own personal playlists that anybody can make.
Yeah, so we'll just dump this on people and they can take it or leave it.
There.
He doesn't need another box set at this point because I don't think he's done enough good since the last one to actually...
Yeah.
Actually get a box set, but it does need an outtakes compilation would be good.
Mm.
So, collect a lot of the bonus tracks and stuff that have happened since 2000.
Yeah.
So people can have them in one place and not have to go get multiple copies of mediocre albums just to get the good stuff.
Yeah. There are, at the very least, 3 songs from this album that could go, and these bonus tracks should have been on there. This would have been a much better album with that stuff gone and this stuff on it.
Definitely.
Got something to say about On My Mind? Then call the telephone line voicemail.
6238503375. Call now. On my mind. And I just can't forget her. She's on my mind. And I can make it better.
We'll be back in a moment after these incredibly perfect segues. Ugh, I can just eat this stuff up.
And now back to Face the Music.
I'm afraid that this track falls into a selector list of songs worthy of inclusion in the main album, but for whatever reason, it is regaled to bonus tracks, especially for the Japanese market, the lucky bastards. The lyrics may not be deep, well, duh, but they don't sound as hollow like the bulk of his outputs and secret messages, and they do add to the mood. To me, what makes this a stand-up is the dramatic music and arrangement, and the drumming that has a nice kick during the chorus. In fact, the chorus certainly levelates this into ELO atmosphere, unlike the Zoom tracks and large parts of Alone. Dirty to the Bone barely has enough jet fuel to light a fart compared to this. Again, the mood crescendos is the nitro here, especially that electrical wave that buzzes right through during the middle of the chorus. Cool. The album got some decent reviews compared to Zoom, and I get the feeling that if this track was included, well, you get the idea by now. Damn it, Japan.
ELO fans, this is Mike Hudson, and this week I've got something on my mind. Well, my review for the song On My Mind, that is. On My Mind is the bonus track on the Japanese version of Alone in the Universe, and it's a really good song. I wish they had put this song on the world bonus version of the album and swapped it out with Fault Line. Let the Japanese have Fault Line as their bonus track, and I could have saved myself some money getting the copy of the Japanese CD. Before I go any further, this will probably already be brought up by Eric 1 or Eric 2 or someone else, but the chorus part of this song reminds me a lot of Lonesome Lullaby from Zoom. It's not exactly the same, but it's similar. But aside from that, it's a great song. I have no problem with this song at all. I like the electric piano that starts the song out with the synthesized strings and choir in the background. And then as the drums and bass kick in, we also get some other keyboard sounds. And then in the bridge portion of the song, we get this nice fuzzy guitar tone that I really haven't heard Jeff using before. It's a nice touch. I like it when Jeff tries different sounds in the songs. Then there's this nice little chord change that couples the chorus back up to the second verse. I like how Jeff uses his telephone voice in the bridge sections of the song. Unless my ears are failing me, on the intro of this song, Jeff's using just a little touch of reverb on his voice, which is something he almost never does. Of course, he tightens up the vocals later on in the song, dropping the reverb entirely. He does this as well on occasion. I kind of wonder if the reason this wasn't included on the standard album was because Jeff noticed that there was a musical similarity between this song and Lonesome Lullaby. Could be the reason it was relegated to being a bonus track on the Japanese version. Honestly, this song in blue should have been included as standard tracks on the Alone in the Universe standard album. That album was short enough that these two songs could easily have been added with no problem at all. The 10-song standard version only runs about 32 minutes and 31 seconds. Adding these two songs would only gotten it up to about 38 minutes, which is well under the 44-minute commonly accepted standard for maximum LP running time. I seem to have read or heard Jeff say somewhere that his manager was the one who would suggest to him to have bonus tracks for his albums. His manager knows that us diehard fans are going to buy the alternate versions of the LPs and CDs if they have something extra on them. Yeah, it's a good money-making strategy, but totally unnecessary. Well, at least to me it's unnecessary. I was actually surprised when the next album, From Out of Nowhere, came out, and there wasn't a bonus track version of that one. Instead, we got the gold LP version. I forget, were there other versions? I only have the CD, the black vinyl LP, and the gold LP. Anyway, if you don't have the Japanese version of this CD, you really should consider getting it, because On My Mind is a great song. It's a departure from the usual Jeff Lynne sound these days. Well, I'm glad I got all that off my mind. See you next go round. Mike Hudson, out.
Well, hey, this is Troy, and when I first heard On My Mind, and I'm sure I'm not the first person to notice this. I know the comment section on YouTube, about every other comment said this, so I'm sure I'm not the first one in this group to notice this. But it reminded me of Lonesome Lullaby from Zoom. You know, cry, baby, cry, and on my mind. So, there's that. I love the tempo changes in the song. In fact, the tempo changes twice before the verse goes into the chorus. You have the first change where the guitar really kicks in, and then you have the transition to the chorus, and that transition reminded me of the transition from the verse to the chorus in Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers into the Great Wide Open. It's like... And of course, Jeff Lynne produced that, so I don't know if he's cribbing himself or not. I think this song might have been a good B-side for a single off of Armchair Theater. I don't completely hate the song. In a way, it sounds like three songs rolled into one, but that could just be serendipitous. And another thing I like about this song, the lyrics, especially in the verses. I mean, I know Jeff has written and sung about heartbreak before, but these lyrics kind of hit home for me. I mean, if you've ever been in a relationship and the other person in that relationship decides they want to move on, but you don't want to, but you know that you have to let them go. Yeah, I can relate to these words, still on my mind, you know, all these years later, still on my mind. There's one person from my past, I met her about 35 years ago, and I haven't seen her or talked to her in over 20 years. And this is a situation that was never resolved, really. And yeah, I think about her often. So this song kind of resonated with me in a way that some of his other heartbreak songs may not have. I kind of give it maybe a 6 out of 10. And next week, Alone in the Universe. Oh boy. And I'll talk to you later. This has been A Thought from Troy.
Like it? Hate it? What does Madeline think?
I love the song.
Wow, she liked it!
Face the Music, an Electric Light Orchestra song-by-song podcast, is a production of Radio Trolla Entertainment, Assorted Deli Meets Amalgamated. You can contact us by voicemail at 623-850-3375 or email us at eloftmpodcast@gmail.com. Keep up to date on the show by joining our Facebook group and spread the word by sharing the link or giving us a quick rating on iTunes. You can financially support the podcast at patreon.com/ELOpod. Next week, Alone in the Universe bonus tracks.
Okay.